Hello, and welcome to Demand Driven Matters, the podcast that addresses all things related to demand-driven manufacturing. Today, we're going to talk about modern demand-driven manufacturing and the strategies for enabling the industrial Internet of Things, smart manufacturing, Industry 4.0, and more. Before we get started, let's review our definition of demand-driven manufacturing. Demand-driven manufacturing enables a synchronized, closed-loop between customer orders, production scheduling, and manufacturing execution, all while synchronizing the flow of materials and resources across the supply chain. The key components are synchronization and flow. When we refer to modern demand-driven manufacturing, we're layering on three key elements: digitization, synchronization, and visualization. I'll go through each of these in a bit more detail and take you through some actual business use cases. And then we'll talk about some strategies for using these elements to enable smart manufacturing. First, when we talk about digitization, we're making the right data accessible and putting it in the hands of the right people for smart manufacturing decision making. When we talk about synchronization, we're aligning people, processes, materials, machines, and data at the order level to drive end-to-end production flow. With visualization, we're instantly communicating changes in demand and priorities to everyone, creating a single version of the truth. First, digitization and liberating your data. The convergence of manufacturing digitization and cloud technologies not only frees your data, but makes it so much easier to access, aggregate, analyze, and transform it into meaningful, actionable information. In a moment, we'll talk more about the deeper meaning provided through contextual data, but data liberation gives us greater insight to take action and automate through a continuous loop of real-time data. This is key for quickly adapting to changes in demand and priorities. In their manufacturing transformation, Orbital ATK's high-level objectives were to increase rate and enable smart manufacturing and the industrial Internet of Things through Factory of the Future technology. A big part of their initiative was to liberate their data, making it easily accessible to the right people at the right time to make the right decision. For Orbital ATK, it started with connecting their data assets and empowering their people with tools to aggregate, analyze, and share information to enable smart manufacturing decision-making. Today, they're able to see the real-time status of multiple machines and sensors through a single screen. This gives them the ability to quickly pinpoint issues and resolve problems. A good example of where this really adds value is in their autoclave, where parts can bake for up to 12 hours. Imagine if they're able to detect a quality issue even 1 hour into that cycle, how much time that saves them. Through digitization and greater connectivity across all their assets, they've been able to dramatically reduce downtime and keep production flowing, which, among other things, has contributed to a greater than 400% rate increase. What they have today is an environment with greater transparency, access to real-time information with the ability to drill down into the data for root cause analysis, all within an agile, scalable architecture that will adapt as their needs change. To summarize, they've built a platform that they can continually build upon as a means to connect their people, materials, machines, processes, and data. They've empowered everyone with information to drive quality decisions. And they're continually refining their processes with data-driven continuous improvement. Next, let's talk about synchronization, one of the key elements of demand-driven manufacturing. According to our friends at Gartner, synchronization is one of the first requirements for a demand-driven manufacturing environment. What that means is taking an order-centric view and focusing on the value stream, aligning everything you need to complete an order before releasing work into production. This drives end-to-end production flow. Let's look at an example. GIW Minerals, a KSB company, transitioned to demand-driven manufacturing to manage these issues. Today, they've optimized their production flow and have a better handle on cycle times through synchronization. Let's review how they got there. Today, when they receive an order, their scheduling system, Sync Manufacturing Software, reviews the requirements and synchronizes all the necessary resources to complete the order based on the customer's delivery requirements. Once all the elements to complete the order are in sight, the order is deemed ready for production. Then the order is released into production based on the optimal rate of flow. Think of it like a metered on-ramp. Cars are released onto the freeway at a rate that reduces congestion and keeps traffic flowing. Next, let's talk about visualization as a strategy for modern demand-driven manufacturing. Remember, modern demand-driven manufacturing is based on actual custom orders or consumption, that is demand rather than a forecast. And because demand-driven manufacturers operate in real or near real time, the coordination of people, materials, machines, and processes can be quite complex and highly variable. When executed well, however, the trade-off is real. All relevant KPIs are moving in the right direction, including increased capacity, right-sized inventory, greater on-time delivery, and improved profitability. Visibility really matters and becomes a catalyst for simplification. Here are the core areas modern demand-driven manufacturers focus on when it comes to visibility. Demand and supply. The real-time synchronization and visibility of the demand signal, material availability, and execution drives uninterrupted and end-to-end production flow. For fully automated demand-driven manufacturers, this level of visibility typically results in higher rates of on-time delivery because all production variables are synchronized and scheduled against the customer's required delivery date. Production flow indicators. Because synchronization and production flow represent the foundation of modern demand-driven manufacturing, having visibility into factors impacting production flow is critical. Real-time visibility into stock buffer levels, constraints, and shop floor events or interruptions can make the difference in profitability. Finally, priorities. Modern demand-driven manufacturing technologies are highly adapted to changes in demand. Subsequent shifts and priorities need to be communicated across the supply chain in real time to maintain optimal flow. For example, schedulers need visibility into available resources to offload work. Operators need visibility into what to work on next. Suppliers need visibility into replenishment adjustments. And service providers need visibility to optimize transportation. REX Materials Group is a progressive organization in terms of applying lean and constraints management principles, yet they were still struggling with these issues. They discovered that by providing greater visibility into order information and priorities, they were able to empower their workers to help resolve the issues. Through cross-training and giving their operators and everyone in their organization visibility into order status and priorities, operators who were caught up on their priorities could see other areas in which they were cross-trained where their help was needed. So in this case, the visualization along with the cross-training really drove strong results. There are countless ways visibility technology delivers value across the supply chain, really too many to address in any one session. We've captured several in the white paper End-to-End Supply Chain Visibility Technology is Here, which is available in the resources section at synchrono.com. Additional information on modern demand-driven manufacturing strategies is available at synchrono.com/resources. Thanks for joining us. Tune in for the next edition of Demand-Driven Matters, the podcast.